A 25-year-old man presents to your office for an initial visit complaining of pain and swelling in his knee joints. In this case, age is important, knee joint pain is important along with swelling, which shows that there might be an inflammation as well as pain of the knee joints. He has just moved to the area and tells you that has avoided physicians most of his young life. He reports that his knee pain is a chronic issue along with the chronic back pain. On physical examination, he has limited range of motion of both his spine as well as knees. He also has dark spots in his conjunctiva as well as nasal bridge. On further questioning, you learn that the water in his toilet bowl turns black if he forgets to flush it after urination. You order X-ray films of his back and knees and send his urine for analysis, expecting to find premature arthritic changes on X-ray film and elevated urine homogentisic acid in the urine analysis. So yes, this is a typical case of alkaptonuria. So what is the deficiency of the enzyme in this? Alkaptonuria is an autosomal recessive disorder associated with the mutation on chromosome number 3. So chromosome 3 is important for your examination over here. An autosomal recessive disorder associated with the mutation on chromosome 3, and the enzyme name is homogentisic acid oxidase. So what is the function of the homogentisic acid oxidase over here? It is responsible mainly for the degradation of tyrosine. So when this homogentisic acid oxidase is defective, there is a buildup of tyrosine and phenylalanine because it is a precursor to tyrosine. So there will be an accumulation as well as buildup of tyrosine and phenylalanine and also homogentisic acid. This homogentisic acid is nothing but intermediate in the tyrosine breakdown. So tyrosine will be accumulated, phenylalanine can be accumulated along with that homogentisic acid. These three products gets accumulated. And the accumulation of the homogentisic acid specifically causes degeneration of cartilage that leads to dark blue discoloration of connective tissue called as ochronosis. Accumulation of the homogentisic acid causes degeneration of cartilage leading to dark blue discoloration of connective tissue known as ochronosis, which is called as the degenerative joint disease, will develop especially at the knee as well as hip joints. And the clinical manifestations are more severe mainly because of homogentisic acid when compared to that of the tyrosine or phenylalanine. So what are the clinical manifestations in alkaptonuria? Increased pigmentation of the ears, nasal bridge, conjunctiva, neck, as well as anterior thorax are the typical manifestations. I'm repeating once again, the areas are very, very important for an exam to identify, because even in this case, we are talking about these things. Increased pigmentation of ears, nasal bridge, conjunctiva, neck, as well as anterior thorax, and arthralgias and incapacitating arthritis of the knee joint, typically of the spine as well as fingers. Mainly knee joints, spine and fingers. So arthritis can be seen. So here, the lab findings are most evident with elevated urine levels of homogentisic acid, which is the dark urine we can say, mainly caused by the polymers of the homogentisate. This you need to write down. Dark urine caused by the polymers of homogentisate. So imagine there will be a premature arthritic changes and cartilaginous calcifications which are seen on the X-ray film, and the symptomatic treatment is the only option which is available in this case. So this is called as alkaptonuria. So majority of the questions which are related to this is like polymers of the homogentisate, which actually responsible for the development of the dark urine. And this is the autosomal recessive disorder with the mutation of the chromosome 3. Right, nowadays no one is asking what is the enzyme which is responsible for this, which is pretty much easy to identify. So this is what is a alkaptonuria.